Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Leroy Mack My Career series here in NBA 2K14 on the Xbox One. Leroy Mack just recently traded to the Wizards, already trying to look for a way out because this team is going nowhere. I believe they're 8-18 to start the year. Ouch. Not exactly where he was looking to get traded. Oh well, we'll see how it goes.
How you liking the NBA so far?
It's all good, man. Getting used to it, you know?
Oh, okay, that's good to hear. Cause you know, I thought the game might be too fast for you.
Come on, man, you talking that stuff already? Look, man, when I start showing up on magazine covers, don't be jealous, alright?
That's right?
Yeah.
How don't we make a little, challenge? Yeah, you outscore me tonight, I'll admit on social media that you're the better player. Which you won't. But, if I outscore you, you're gonna have to try to do the same.
Man, that's the easiest bet I ever made.
A word?
Yeah.
Oh.
But you know what? I don't think it's fair, man. You even got any fans?
Let's find out.
Yes. It's another showdown with Jackson Ellis. Now, to tell you the truth, I can't remember if Leroy has really had one in the NBA with him yet. Obviously, Wally McGee has over in his series, so I don't know. This might have been the first time. I can't remember. Obviously, they met in the showcase. Look at that nifty pass there from Leroy Mack. He's not going to get a lot of assists because, you know, he's me first. But when it's wide open and it's obvious, he wants to show off the skills in the passing game once in a while, too. Here he's going to stop and pop that over Jackson Ellis. And he's got his first 2 points of the ball game. So now remember, he wants to outscore his rival so that he can win the little challenge here. Ellis goes right around him and makes him look bad. Oh, is he hurt? Look at, he's down. He's taking a while to get up. I think he's all right. But we're not going to wait for him to get up. Go down to the other side of the court, and Leroy wants the ball. Leroy wants the ball. A little bit of a screen, and he will hit that shot. So he comes right back and hits his own. So these two are going back and forth here right now. Leroy with 4 points, as he really didn't do much at all in the first half. But this second half, it's going to be his. He's taken over, and he makes 3 of his first 4 shots. Took him a while to get there, but he does, and he gets that mini goal completed, and he draws a foul here, as he already has 7 points, and he's going to be looking for more at the free throw line. So as Leroy is ready to take the first of two, you see Washington's actually got the lead here. Oh, he misses the first one. Ah, doesn't want to have to go and shoot extra free throws after practice again, so doesn't want to miss 2 of 2, and this one will rattle in. So he does make 1 of 2, and Washington's got a 10-point lead. Remains a 10-point lead here, 71-61, and Leroy Mack sizing up the D, and he's going to go up and under, and it's blocked, but there is a foul on Drummond. So he'll go back to the line once again, maybe hoping to get 2 of 2 this time. Boy, takes a lucky bounce right there, and he makes his first. I don't know if he's looking for someone to get a high five from, but nobody's there. Everybody's checking in and out. So he's got 9 points, looking to make it 10, and that one is in as well. So he does make 2 of 2 right there. Leroy Mack keeps his team in the lead. It's 77-65 now, third quarter, about 2 minutes remaining. Mack calling for a screen and looking for a lane to drive. Instead, he'll shoot his short jumper, and he's now got 12 points. Not sure what Jackson Ellis has right now, but I think we're outdoing him at least by a little bit. 79-67, just 1:10 left. Oh, he finds Gortat. Had to give it up there because he's wide open. So even Leroy Mack, who wants to shoot pretty much all the time, defers right there. Here's going to be another foul and another opportunity for free throws. See, the Pistons are a little bit frustrated right now with the foul calls. As Leroy Mack hits the first of two, let's see if we can make it 2 of 2. He's got 13 points. This could be number 14. And it's good. Another 2 of 2 from the line. 83-67 is your lead in the third quarter, but now we're into the fourth, and Leroy Mack, well, he goes cold all of a sudden. Can't hit that shot. Got a foul underneath. And here he's going to try to size up another 3 in front of the Pistons bench. Nope, that one's off the mark. Looking for a little help here. Gives it off to Trevor Ariza. Gets the ball back for a wide open 3, but no, he can't hit that one either. Ice cold right now. Some players, when they're not shooting well, they look to pass. And I guess that's what Leroy did right there as he gets the assist. But you know what? His main remedy for this problem of ice-cold shooting is to just keep shooting. And that one doesn't go. You know, if at first you don't succeed, try again? I don't know, something like that. Leroy just wants to keep shooting it because that's who he is. Unfortunately, he's letting Detroit back in the game here now because they're not getting buckets. Okay, finally he's going to defer to Wall. Wall doesn't want the shot, but he finds Ariza, who's wide open. Oh, good choice right there. He was wide open, and he sinks the three. Okay, up by four. Big inbound here, and Jackson Ellis will have to foul Leroy Mack, sending his rival to the line to shoot free throws. Yeah, that must pain him a little bit to have to do that. Leroy sinks the first one, and the second one would give him a six-point lead, which would be very nice here with 20 seconds left, but no, it clanks off. The rebound by Monroe. It's now a two-point game. Inbound, and once again, Ellis has to foul Leroy Mack. Okay, he needs at least one here. Missing both would be terrible. That would just not be good at all. So the first is good. Okay, so it's a three-point game, and this could all but sink the game if he gets the second, because it would put them up four with under 5 seconds remaining, and it does go. So he makes two of two. 99-95 is your final. The Wizards win, and Leroy Mack outscores Jackson Ellis.
I tell you, now the whole world knows where the real talent lies.
I don't know what happened out there. I thought I had your number in that one for sure. Lucky game, I guess.
Lucky? You know, we got a whole lot more games out here to prove who's got the bigger ego.
Yeah, you're right. Shit, guess I'm gonna have to come out even stronger next time, huh? You're gonna be an afterthought after the next time the game's
over. Ain't happening, Jack. Hey, and you know what? Don't forget to tell the media about my skills tonight, you know, since I won that bet and all.
Yeah. Woo! I was hoping you forgot about that.
Well, it's been a few days, so where do things stand now? Still want to be traded? Because remember, if we go down this road, there's no turning back.
Yeah, I'm definitely ready to get out of here.
All right, I'll see what I can do. But you need to know I'm not going to make a move just for the sake of making a move. I need to ensure it's in the best interest of this organization. I can't promise anything, but why don't you let me know what teams you're interested in?
So here we are, Leroy Mack determined to burn through at least half the league here via trade, and he might get halfway there in the season. So I don't really know who to pick. Obviously, teams who are interested in me, but I really don't want to go to another loser, so this is tough. Let's see how this goes.
Okay. If I can find something that makes sense, you'll get your wish.
Just make it happen. Thanks.
You heard the man. Just make it happen. This team is 9-19 or 9-18, whatever. They're losing a lot of games, and that is even with this last win that they had. So kind of a interesting quirk in the schedule here is you see Jackson Ellis has to pay up on the bet here and say something nice about Leroy Mack over social media. So this actually works out that it's a home-and-home with Detroit. So guess what? They will get on a plane here, fly to Detroit, and take on Jackson Ellis one more time head-to-head. Kind of interesting because now we're probably going to have another confrontation between these two. Not even time to simmer down. It's the very next ball game with this home-and-home situation. Well, let's see how things play out in Detroit.
How's it going, Jack?
Just bowling. Pretty much what you'd expect.
If that's what you call balling.
Think you've been better? That's about the funniest thing I heard all season. You know I got your number, bro.
Man, it's nice to see your self-eval skills are just about as whack as your skills on the court.
You don't even know what you're talking about, dog. Because I'm going to destroy you tonight. Yeah. Let's have a little competition.
All right. Whoever gets outscored has to say something over the top nice about the other dude at the press conference tonight.
I'm all in on that. Time for you to start thinking about something nice you're gonna be saying about me.
No need, dog. It's all you after the night.
Let's find out.
All right.
Now, obviously, that dialogue wasn't meant to be, you know, the second of back-to-back games. It's kind of like they haven't seen each other in a while, but it's kind of curious that Jackson Ellis would come out and say, I got your number, when he just got taken down head-to-head in the game previous. But that's how it is. I'd still rather have those scenes in than not at all and have it just be a little awkward. So here we go. Another matchup with the Pistons and Jackson Ellis. Can he outscore him 2 games in a row? Well, Ellis is getting a little bit of a cushion from Leroy there, and he's going to step back and hit that three. So he's starting out hot. Although Washington does have the lead early on, it's 18-14. Leroy wants to come right back down the court, very next possession, and hit his own three. Yes, it's good. So he's saying, anything you can do, I can do better. And that is what he's doing right there, is hitting the three, matching points for points. Now he's trying to get in the lane on Jackson Ellis. He's not going to let him do it, so he'll just pop his mid-range shot. Has 5 points now. He got a steal by John Wall. Going to give it up to Leroy Mack, knowing he's trying to outdo Jackson Ellis, and kind of gives him a freebie right there. Washington having a strong first quarter and a pretty strong first half overall. They're up by 12, and oh, that one goes off, as it was a last-second three-point attempt. Would not go, but Washington still plays a great first half of basketball on the road. Boy, for a team losing this much, these 2 games have been pretty impressive, or shall we say game and a half. They've still got a half of basketball to play here in Detroit. You see Leroy Mack trying to get open. Going to finally get a pass underneath from Gortat as he's able to score. And Jackson Ellis can do nothing about it. So we got a 10-point game right now. Detroit cutting into that a little bit. The lead is 6. Leroy is going to shoot. Oh, you know he's going to shoot it over Jackson Ellis. And he's going to have to like it. 11 points right there. And Mack is fired up. That ball's going to be tipped and picked off by Ariza. Gets it to John Wall, who gets it to Leroy Mack, who sinks his mid-range. Wow, it bounced around there, but it finally does go. 13 points now, and Mack, recovering on the play, was back behind the action, but they forgot about him. He swipes the ball and gets the fast break dunk, and it's now 85-77 Washington. We got another steal. This one he's going to give off to John Wall. See, he can give every once in a while. Once in a while. There you go. He's just paying back John Wall for his kindness earlier. You know, you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours, kind of a thing. Even Leroy can see the value in that once in a while. Max got the ball on the perimeter, looking for Nene underneath. No, he misses. Gortat misses. This is ugly. But the pass from Nene back out to Leroy Mack, and he nails the three-pointer. He was wide open. That's a huge shot at that point, opening up the lead just a little bit. It's 94-90. He's going to get the pass under to Gortat, and this time the big man makes it. It's a 2-point game with 32 seconds left. A big inbound play here. They choose not to foul. They're going to try to play D. That doesn't work out as he gets the ball to Nene. And it's another assist for Leroy Mack. He knew what to do there. He knew what they needed in order to win the ball game, and they do it. They take back-to-back games against the Pistons. And once again, he outscores Jackson Ellis. So Leroy Mack has a great couple games there. He's named the NBA Rookie of the Month. And oh, by the way, he wants out of Washington as soon as possible. So Jackson Ellis, once again, forced to say something nice over social media. But look at that. Even with 2 wins in a row, we're 10-18. We're hideous. Come on, get Leroy Mack out of town. Let's go. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.